Link.
Hold that thought.
Beloved acolyte, champion of violence, bearing tides raw and sweet as bitten sores. A voice from the deep whispers, in your immortality, Erismorn, may you never cease your demand for vengeance. I refuse. In time, I will destroy this hive form alongside the rest. Its power has no hold over me. Zeboroth will not fall tonight alone. Every clash of blades invigorates her. Even now she feeds, as she has fed since the first red cough, the first war song. Still, I savor every tithe. Their strength thrills me, and there are so many old debts to repay. But this is not the time. The cards speak of change. A ripple is cast. A great shadow rises from the sea of blood. Something is coming.
you hear it? The thrumming of her battle song. Zeevu Aroth's brood has come.
We will make of my sister's court a battlefield!
Break those void crystals to release their power.
The helium drinkers, the ammonites,
We sounded their end with our blades. The Ecumene, the Harmony, they wailed in terror as we sang their extinction. Humanity has joined the chorus of our war eternal.
What is she doing? Zebu Aroth issues her challenge.
You've really done it now. You need to chase Zebu's goons out of here before they take over.
Guardian down. Guardian down.
Transfer the arc charge to each crystal.
Thank you.
Eris Morn. Your brood arms themselves with my brother's mantle. Your acolytes pay tribute by my brother's law. Feed your worm as I feed mine. I shall test my strength against your vengeance. We will have our times. You drove my sister to her throne, and she found true death by your comprehension. You chased my brother to his throne, and he fell as his children by your assiduity.
And so you will fall.
Come, my court is war, and you will find me there.
Drive Zeevu Aroth from this place, or she will overrun the throne world and take the tithes I am owed.
You crave as I crave. You love as I love. Prove yourself with your existence, as I have proved my own. I will kill you over and over, forever and ever. Our war is as my brother's love. Ayat.
I am no sister to you.
know that there is only war. You prove my logic true. Meet me in blood. Match me in violence. Our brutes will feed us with their tribute.
Zivu Arath, when this is finished, you will turn and run, and your worm will gnaw at you as if you were a buried corpse. You will have no tribute then, and you will starve.
This isn't over. Zivu will keep coming until she wins her war.
We need to rethink our plan.
No. Our plan needs no revision. Her presence proves its efficacy. We must press on.
We can't fight her.
But we can hold the line until a way forward is found. Guardian, proceed to the Witch Queen's wretched oubliette. Claim the tithes before Zivu Arath takes them as spoils of her eternal war.
I don't like this.
You don't need to.
Timing. I was just looking.
All right, you're here. This is serious, so listen, and listen good. Zivu Arath's forces got into the throne world. This wasn't part of the plan. But it's bad news for everybody. Savathun's been hoarding powerful creatures in those summoning pits for a long time. Partially to study, but also to keep them out of the hands of her sister. If Zivu is able to take that extra power for herself, forget it! We're all dead! You need to claim those tithes. I hate seeing it all wasted on that weirdo heiress. But it's better than the alternative. Time to get to work, hero. The boss was hoping it wouldn't come to this, but only amateurs rely on wishful thinking. Listen to this.
If Zeevu Arath learns what the Guardians are up to in my oubliette, she'll do what she always does. Attack. Lucky for us, her poor Wrathborn are so eager to die. They'll make lovely ties. Provided the Guardians survive long enough to collect them.
When I discovered the Spire, I saw heresy. A temple of the sky. I sought to destroy it. But now, I see truth. It is built on a foundation of death. A temple of the sword. Logic so pure, even the warriors of the sky honor it.
Rituals are discovered by the Eater of Weakness, the god on the rotten slave, Zivu Arath. Show her that the logic of the sword is no longer the hive of the bird. Five's eternal sword poised to strike down the world.
Liar, enemy, worshiper. You would disavow me, even as you lay tribute at my feet. Turn your weapons against me, for I am the destruction you create.
Sivu-Arath would lay claim to all conflict, but she is no longer the only high-regarded striver. Wrest these tributes from her grasp. Exalt me with your violence, as you have always done!
back with reinforcements once Zivu's brood is assembled.
Sometimes I think the boss believes in you more than her own brood. She left this for you.
If the Guardians survive my sister's assault, it'll be on account of their ferocity, not their clemency. Zivu Arath will be thrilled. The Guardians will claim self-defense, of course. But that self-deception will only work for so long. Eventually, they'll have to admit, they live by the sword as much as my sister does. It's so nice when the people we love all get along. Don't you think?
Guardian, good work out there.
I can hardly believe the tactical reports I'm writing. Vanguard forces, pursuing tithes to Hive Commune Eris Morn, have engaged Zivu Arath's troops in Savathun's throne world. We are caught between the sister gods of combat and lies, and we're trying to resurrect the one who's caused us the most suffering. Even if we win, we lose. We accepted an impossible bargain. Savathun knew we couldn't defeat Zivu Arath. No one can win a battle against war itself. Eris understands this better than any of us. I know she's working on a plan. But I must still prepare for unexpected outcomes. If her transformation is influencing her judgment, how would I know? What could I even do to keep her safe? Guardian, be careful. We've lost so much to the Hive already. We can't let them take any more.
So, you're really taking on Zivu Arath's top general. I love watching you do our dirty work. I was digging through Savathun's archives. I found this little gem from about a million years ago. I figured you should know what you're up against.
Geoma Essie, research log, the Veil. Geoma Essie, research log, the Veil. We shouldn't settle here. It's a mistake. But Maya is insistent that we have to build our long-term shelters near the Veil. We're almost done constructing an enclosure around it. Once the field emitters are up, they should at least be safe from its radiation. The SIVA tech Maya had on the Exodus was a lifesaver. Not only for building the enclosure, but shelters, tools. We'd be dead without it. Chioma Essie, incident log. The Vex. Chioma Essie, research log. Exos. Chioma Essie, research log. SIVA. SIVA is a nanotech fabrication system, intended to be used by Exodus ships to rapidly build necessary resources from base matter. Maya calls it Willow Bray's obsession, without a hint of self-awareness. But we both see the potential it poses for the future. Each nanomachine in SIVA's design is an independent, thinking machine, utilizing a distributed quantum network to coordinate movement. Like a mechanical version of Radiolaria. Probably where the design was inspired from, if I'm being honest. But the design can be pushed. We're looking at ways of incorporating components from disabled Vex and erased Exomines. If we can insulate the nanomachines from the radiation that killed the Exos, maybe... maybe their deaths won't be for nothing.
Wait, does this really mean I'm part Vex?
Well, it's too early to jump to these conclusions, Nimbus. But there does seem to be some connection between the Vex and the Cloud Striders. It may explain why you and the others are able to enter the Vex network without the aid of splicers.
Can I time travel?
No, let's hope not.
Thank you. Hello, Guardian. Welcome.
What do you think?
Good. You're back. A prepared soldier is a victorious soldier. Very good. Back to the front, Guardian.
You're one of the best. The Iron Banner breaks the best.
Yes. Check. Thank you, thank you.
Eververse trades in goods we fear enhance a Guardian's journey.
Light doesn't grow unless you feed it worthy opponents.
Fight the good fight.
People need to feel safe here.
Trust me, this is worth the price.
All of them?
And what can I do for you? Careful out there. Are you judging me for selling out and moving back to the city? You are judging me. Birds. Did you want to talk to me? Clan cookouts. We could get the Vanguard to sponsor and... No.
Time to snag another submine fragment, Guardian. Get in and out before they even know what's hit them.
Now. Zeebo Aroth's battle song emboldens her soldiers. End it.
Locked down tight, but the maintenance shafts are just big enough to fit you and all that armor. Happy crawling.
I never knew there was a submind housed in Europa. Neither did the Vanguard's archives. Which submind is this?
I had the same question. Turns out it's not really a submind, not in the traditional sense. It's more like a foundational AI framework they all use. Big shrieky eye. Guardian, get gouging.
jump.
On this before. I never got it to work right.
Your grandfather seems confident he can rebuild Rasputin's core systems.
Yeah, only Red's not just code, Osiris. He developed personhood, autonomy. I don't want to take that from him.
Rasputin drifts in limbo. But with this, the Warmind can find what he once was. Sometimes, that opportunity is all we can ask for.
A transaction to make, Guardian?
great news!
It's good to see you alive, Guardian. I was wondering.
Lucent Hive, risen by the trap.
Sometimes. Well, not.
I can fix this.
What if the Traveler is not what we thought it was?
Perhaps a barter is warranted.
What if the Traveler is not what we thought it was?
Physical expressions won't win a fight. This unit functioning at 98.3% at performance.
What if the Traveler is not what we thought it was? By the Traveler. Hive, risen by the Traveler.
Bad rattle, very bad.
What if the Traveler is not what we thought it was?
Dead orbit package, spare parts, leaking. Oh dear.